Reverend Molly House Gordon.
Good morning. As Claire said, I'm Reverend Molly House Gordon. I'm here from the Unitarian Universalist Church of Columbia. And I'm here to bring a spirit of blessing upon this gathering and also to bring my gratitude. As a person of faith and as a clergy person, I am so grateful for your gathering here together to stand on the side of love and justice. I'm grateful because I know that that is the right side. And I want to remind you this morning, I want to invoke the spirit and power of the prophetic tradition, reminding you that we are here in prophetic witness. We are here in prophetic witness to declare that discrimination based on sexual and gender identity is immoral and should be illegal. We are here also to celebrate every person who lives into the fullness of their identity, to celebrate and praise the truth and love that comes into the world when we are authentically ourselves. And that is worth praising. We are also here this morning in prophetic witness to declare that keeping loving couples from the social and legal benefits of marriage is immoral and should be illegal. And we are here to celebrate love in its every embodiment, to celebrate the power that comes into the world with loving relationship and commitment. And so I celebrate and bless this gathering this morning, reminding you that we are standing together on the side of love and holding my faith that love, the transforming and sustaining power of love, is on our side, and that it will not be denied. Blessings upon your gathering today. Amen.
A different article
that hit my inbox. I'd like to tell you a little bit about a woman who I don't know at all, but her story, the tiny blurb about her in the paper this morning, really hit home at the hard work we're doing. On Monday afternoon, Sergeant Lucy Miller died. She's a St. Louis police officer. She died off duty at an accident on her ever home. Her obituary said she was survived by her daughter, five brothers, and her domestic partner. Her domestic partner, not her spouse, not her wife, her domestic partner. To me, she's the hero. When the timeline of our history is written, you're going to see the names like Edith Windsor, Supreme Court cases like the Prop 8 case. You're going to see Matthew Shepard's life writ large. We already see that in the, on the handwriting on the wall. Unfortunately, the unsung hero, like Sergeant Lucy Miller, don't receive that recognition. Briefly, I'd like to ask for a moment of silence to recognize Sergeant Lucy. Today, I would like you to remember that each and every one of you is a hero for equality. You're here doing the work that advances the issues right here at home. Despite what may happen with the Supreme Court, whether it goes in our favor or it doesn't, Promo will still be here working to advance basic protections. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart for being a part of that movement. We couldn't do it without you. I want to make sure now that we recognize some of our other heroes who have been here with us on equality. I'm going to actually turn it over to Claire Cook to let her do some of the brief introductions of our state representatives.
We're going to begin with State Senator Scott Sifton.
Community. It has been a Senate to carry a bullying bill, an anti-bullying bill that includes specific enumerations to protect individuals in the LGBTQ community. And I look forward to continuing to fight in the Missouri Senate on non-discrimination, which is a topic I'm still hoping we will get to this year. It was my honor to support non-discrimination in the House, and I have to say I was ecstatic as a first-term House member that we even had a vote on non-discrimination and that we had bipartisan support for it. So, the President is fond of quoting Dr. King and saying, the long arrow of history bends toward justice, and we are seeing that happen before our very eyes, not just in the national picture, but also here under this rotunda in the Missouri Capitol. And I cannot tell you how excited and proud I am to be a part of it. It is my hope, particularly on non-discrimination, that we can get to a place, surely we can all agree, that no individual should be discriminated against in their employment on the basis of their orientation. We have no place for it. I know there are many people here in this rotunda today who are personally affected by it. I have friends, I have immediate family members, I have acquaintances, I have coworkers that this protection is very important to me. And I also represent thousands of constituents for whom non-discrimination protection is very badly needed. And so I look forward to continuing this fight along with you. And I want to echo something that AJ said, and it's very important. When he said that you are heroes for equality, he means it. I cannot tell you how important it is for us here in this building and what an impact it makes for us here in this building to have folks who get in their car and drive 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hours just to come and let their voices be heard on the issues that are important to them. And don't think for 1 minute that your presence in this building, that your presence on the rotunda here this morning, talking to your state representatives and senators, don't think for 1 minute that it doesn't matter. Every time you do it, it moves the needle that much more. Whether they're with you or against you, whether they know something about the issue or whether they don't, it is so important for the people, the men and women who represent you here, to hear from you. So thank you all for coming today and for being part of what I sincerely hope will be a historic year for equality. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Judy Morgan. I represent the School District in Kansas City. And I first want to just say thank you to AJ and Claire for all their hard work that they do on behalf of Promo. And let's give both of them a big hand.
If it wasn't for your support, if it wasn't for AJ's help over the years. You know, I'm also one of the few lawyers down here, and I take my role very seriously. I debate on the floor, pardon the pun, I'm usually the straight guy. You know, I try to highlight to the folks on both sides of the aisle where they just don't get it, where they say one thing to their constituents and they come down here and they do another. And I'm known for that, but I had a little moment yesterday where the Supreme Court arguments were over with. I went to the internet and started reading some of the articles and some of the transcripts, and you know, I got a little choked up. And I didn't think I would, because again, I'm a lawyer, I'm a straight guy, it's like, no. And I thought to myself, you know what, after having a partner of 20 years that puts up with me, then this really might happen. But you know what, we have a lot of, this is a term of endearment, what I'll call grizzled warriors out there. You know, folks from my generation, the generation before us, that have been fighting, it seems like forever, just trying to get recognition, starting with the HIV crisis. But I think the real players, the real movers, the real shakers, the real folks that are changing the hearts and minds of people all across the nation are you folks under 30. And you're the ones that are coming out. You're the ones that are proud of who you are, whose parents, maybe fundamentalist Christians, all of a sudden are okay with their son or daughter being gay and now want them to be treated just like anybody else. But also the problems we have, not just with marriage, probably the fact that you can be fired because of your sexual orientation. So, point being, please keep up the good fight. Don't forget to thank our straight allies, because we wouldn't be where we are today if it weren't for them. And if you have a moment, AJ's got a list of majority party members, we call them Republicans, that support a lot of the things that we want to do. Please understand, Missouri is a red state, and it's a conservative red state. And it takes courage for these members of the majority party to do the right thing. So if you don't go see anybody else, go by and see the Republicans that work with Cuomo, that support the Non-Discrimination Act, and just thank them. They're getting emails from constituents. Some of them are thanking, some of it is, what are you doing? We're going to primary you next year. So just thank them for the support. Thank you for being here. If I do anything else, please say it.
Representative Stacey Newman. Good morning. Thanks so much for being here. And we're trying to make this close go back because we have some action on the House floor. We have to get back up. But I want to say, as an activist at heart, it's not like originally got here, thank you. Your presence, your voice here at the Capitol. Can't stress enough how important it is. And I want to paraphrase probably the most popular person on the planet, probably the most popular person in the universe, in terms of equal rights are human rights. And that's the thing that I think we need to take as our message from here on out. Human rights, equal rights, they're all the same. And also, as a mom and as a nana of three little ones, we all know that as young people, this is a no-brainer. And so I've worked so hard, not just to convince my own colleagues, but to actually support and help those of the next generation coming up and understand that this is common sense. This is how we treat people. And so you can count on all of us, all of my colleagues on the floor. We will argue till our time is up, till they can no longer allow us to speak or silence us. So please, please, thanks for being here. Of your own voices. Thank you. Republican State Representative Kevin Engler.
Good morning. I hope you all happy to be here today. I'm happy to be here talking with you. I was asked to talk about one aspect of how you approach some of the Republican members. One of the things I would talk about, some of us are not in tune with you on the marriage issue. But all of them, in particular, the ones that profess themselves to be right-wing Christian fundamentalists, should be with you on the non-discrimination. There's no place in my Bible where I can ever find that we should persecute people. No place. And when Missouri is one of the handful of states that still allows somebody, when they say that they're gay or lesbian, that they can be fired for just cause. So I would tell you, talk to the representative and say, do you think that's right? Would you at least support us on making that illegal? Because as your Bible would tell you, and my God and Jesus tells me, that I should not be persecuting people. I should be doing the right thing with people. That doesn't mean that they need to go completely with everything that you agree with, but at least establish some common ground where you say, don't you agree that somebody should not be fired simply because they admit that they are? And if they can't, every Republican group I talk to when I bring up this subject, because I will say that I don't agree with my party on everything, and here's some of the reasons for other things. Very few people in the state of Missouri even realize that that's legal. You need awareness. And you can't jump from here to here sometimes. You have to jump from here to here. Would you agree that that's unfair? Would you agree that that's unchristian to do that? Well, would you agree to help us change that? And that's how we approach people. Good luck today. Stop by with you. Thank you.
Let me take a little further. Why not go about discrimination? Let's take a look. stand up and let your voices be heard. That's how I got where I am. But how did I get here? You all know me. So to make sure that we do what it is you need us to do, make sure your voices are heard, make sure you let us know what you stand for, what it is you want. And I tell you this, I am very proud of Representative Kalama. He's sponsored the bill, he asked me, and I co-sponsored the bill. And I am very pleased with what we both stand for, and that's to make sure that everyone is treated equally and fair in the state of Missouri. God bless you, have a good day, and good to see you all later.
Difference between those ideals and the world in which we live. We can only do it together. We've made so much progress. The country is buzzing with this movement and this opportunity. And I'm so proud to be a part here in Jeff City of our mission of closing that gap between our ideals and our world. I was very proud to co-sponsor the anti-bullying bill with Stephen. And I just want to say, whatever work we do here, it means very little without the active support and engagement of all of you coming here, getting in front of legislators, helping folks in this building understand that this is not just a set of words on a paper, this is part of the movement. Thank you for being here.
Or may say things like, just stop by, or hold them on.
you're a full nerd, or we can explain it to you individually as well. Please make sure to make these appointments a priority, and then once you've made those a priority, you can go and meet with your own elected officials, and those are listed on your folders as well. And you can also go in and visit the Senate or House galleries and watch the debates. And like I said, there's lots of cool stuff to do in the Capitol, and those are explained in the folders. If you are the member of the team who has the lobby team information sheet, and it has lots of information, and on the back it maybe says a team name on the back of it, after I'm done talking, just hold it up, and all of the team members will come and find you. So maybe it says like Lidla or Rupp on the back of it. Hold it up, and everyone will come and find you. And your team name is again written on the folder. And lastly, just as a reminder, our base camp is again in the Senate alcove, which is on the third floor towards the front of the building. And we'll be there the rest of the day to answer questions. We'll have snacks. We have, I think we have an amazing day. And again, if you have any questions, if things are not written on your folder, come to that table and we'll finish it all up. Okay? Thank you so much for being here. I hope you have an amazing day. Thank you so much for bringing more cities to this one state. Thank you so much.